You won't hear it. Let's go to the malt box.
Okay. Good morning. Thank you all very much for joining us today. My name is Carrie Davis. I'm with the League of Women Voters of Ohio. And it's very appropriate that we are in the gathering today in the Ladies Gallery, because today, August 26th, is a day that we at the League of Women Voters like to celebrate as Women's Equality Day. It marks the 95th anniversary of women's right to vote being enshrined in the U.S. Constitution. That same year, the League of Women Voters was founded in 1920, both nationally and here in Ohio. And for 95 years, the League has worked for the protection and equality of all voters. And we're here today because gerrymandering threatens that equality. We are releasing today, and you'll have in your packets, a new report on the state of gerrymandering in Ohio. It is a follow-up to a report that we did following the 2012 elections that was the same title, Predictable Results, that was looking at the redistricting lines that were drawn in 2011 and how they played out in the 2012 elections. Today's report is a follow-up, continuing to follow how those district lines were drawn and played out in both the 2012 and 2014 races. And this is a report we plan to continue publishing every 2 years, following how these gerrymandered maps have played out for the voters of Ohio, until such time as we finally succeed in getting redistricting reform. I want to invite my colleague, Ann Henkener, up. She has been leading the League's redistricting reform work for a number of years and is going to talk a little bit about the history of that.
Which in a redistricting world is a very brief period of time. I need to mention Jeff Lawrence, who started the fight for a better redistricting method shortly after 1971, which is the first time we did it under our new constitutional amendment. I think that some important stuff in our history is that we have learned the lesson that we really need support from both parties in order to deal with something like redistricting. And Senator LaRose back there, I just have to say, because he has been such a help in this struggle and trying to work through the ideas behind something that's going to work for a bipartisan solution to the problem. In 1981, the League worked on an effort that Republicans supported. In 2012, we worked on an effort that the Democrats supported, and both of those lost. So we're pretty fast learners. We figured out that we really do need something for an issue that is this politically important. We do need something that works for both political parties and that works for the voters. And I think that's what we've gotten here. We find ourselves historically. It's kind of the first part of the decade that is the important part to get something done on redistricting. And we find ourselves in that little window. It needs to be after the last time you're redistricted, so everybody knows how horrible it was. And it needs to be before everybody knows who's going to get to do it next time. So I think we're right in that window of opportunity to get some reform accomplished. I will turn this back over to Carrie, who can talk a little bit more about the problem.